Okay, good afternoon. So we're gonna wait just a minute or two because so far I've never had a tutorial yet where everyone came in, everyone that was coming arrived on time, and it would be, it's better for us to just start all together. So we're gonna wait just a minute or two to see if anyone else is going to trickle in. Okay, so today we're going to be doing some structured writing time in the tutorial this week. What that means is we have these tutorial questions on e-learning, the week two tutorial questions. They are going to they are your task for today. You're going to write them as if they were exam questions, except, one second, there's someone in the waiting room and I need to send them a message. I'm coming back to this. Going on. The thing that this is, that's going to be different from an exam here is that you're not going to have to just limit yourself to whatever you are able to figure out. You can ask questions, you can, you know, sort of have a conversation, right? And so you can ask questions in the chat, or you can unmute and ask them just by speaking if that's your preference. So that's the idea, is that this is going to be a space where you can work through these issues sort of together. If you finish writing your answers, Go ahead and upload them to e-learning and you're free to leave. You don't have to. You are welcome to stay and possibly listen and participate in any conversation that another student raises, but you don't have to stay. You also don't have to rush to finish by the end of the session. If 3 o'clock rolls around and you're not done, you should feel free to keep working and upload at your leisure anytime this week. Okay, so with that, I'm gonna turn you guys loose and let you work. And if you have questions, feel free to ask them again, chat or via voice, your choice. The questions that you're working on are the week two tutorial questions. I'm not lying to you. So so numerous clauses is the principle that says that there's a limitation on the number of, on the ways in which you can structure a property interest. That simple. No, it doesn't limit investment at all. It limits the types of interests that are allowed. So think about the example from Professor Render's article, right? I'm not allowed to sell you my car, but retain the right to drive it every day that Barbados and Trinidad play each other in cricket, right? That's not allowed. So I either have to sell you the car or keep it. So I'm not sure what you're asking, to be perfectly frank. I don't understand what you mean by limiting investment. Okay. Well, I apologize if I was unclear. Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay, so we're about halfway through the session. If you are looking to complete your answers during the session, now is the point where you should probably start transitioning into writing your second answer. Again, you do not have to finish, so you should feel free to take your time and make sure that you've covered all the ground that you think needs to be covered.
Thank you.
About 15 minutes left today, so you guys should continue to make progress, bring your questions into the group, and we'll continue moving toward wrapping this up. Thank you. Yes, Alika, what's your question? Okay, there we go.
Good afternoon, sir. Can you hear me?
I can hear you. What's up?
Okay, I had a question for number three, where it says, does the Law of Property Act 1925 override the numerous clauses to create a new interest in property? So my understanding of numerous clauses is that it limits the rights of people, of persons to property. That's correct, right? Is that the problem that
I'm trying to make sure that I'm understanding what you're saying correctly. So you're suggesting that the numerous clauses limits the substantive rights that people have over their property?
No, as in the number of people that have rights over the property.
No. That's not what numerous clauses does at all. Numerous clauses limits the forms that interests in land can take.
Okay.
This, so we discussed this in the lecture on Thursday, that under numerous clauses, there are, in the Commonwealth Caribbean, there are three forms of interests that interests in land can take: the fee simple, the determinable interest, and the life estate. Right? In the United States, the leasehold is also an interest in land, but in the Caribbean and elsewhere in the Commonwealth, leases are treated as personal property. But the Law of Property Act says that there are three kinds of legal interests in land, okay? The fee simple, the life estate, and the term of years absolute, which is a lease. All other interests in land are classified as equitable interests, okay? And the difference between a legal interest and an equitable interest is not really important at this point, but the question that you're being asked in number three is, does the creation of the lease as a legal interest in land override the numerous clauses in such a way that judges who have used numerous clauses to declare that leases are personal property, right, are in fact misinterpreting the law? So that's the question that you're being asked in number three.
Okay, thank you so much, sir.
About 3 minutes to go, so if there's any more questions, let's get them out. Let's get them out the door. Thank you. Okay, and that's time. So again, if you're not finished, don't worry about it. Just feel free to finish it on your own time and upload tomorrow or Wednesday or anytime this week to e-learning. And we'll see you guys tomorrow in the lecture.